May I speak to you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Have you ever popped into the supermarket just for one item, only to discover that they've changed the layout? Suddenly, you find yourself dashing up and down the aisles, eyes frantically searching, scanning all the items. You knew where it used to be. You know that it will be somewhere in the shop. And all you can think is pasta, pasta, pasta. You go up and down the whole shop, up and down the aisles, and because your eyes are so focused on scanning new things, you miss what it was that you were looking for in the first place. Suddenly, your eyes go upward, and the sign over the aisles tells you where everything is. Signs come in all shapes and sizes. Many of you will know that on Angel Hill is a large old signpost that seems a little out of place now. Also known as the Pillar of Salt, the plaque at the bottom tells us it's thought to be the first internally illuminated road sign in the country. Signposts are everywhere, telling us where to go or where we've come from. It's a form of communicating. An even older form of communicating is with beacons, fires lit at the top of the tallest hills to communicate something over a vast distance to another village or group of people. In our gospel reading today, Simeon and Anna are like signposts themselves. They stand at a central point of time, looking back at the prophecies foretold in the ancient scriptures, waiting for God's word to become a reality. They stand in the present, actually looking at the prophecies fulfilled in Jesus Christ. And they look to the future, to the pain and suffering of the Christ to come. Because of the coronavirus, we have found ourselves waiting and waiting. And here we can have some sympathy with Anna and Simeon. Patience and trust are exceedingly difficult to be consistent. Simeon and Anna's patience and devotion to God was an anchor to their beliefs. Although their own lives must have been very challenging, their faith was so strong that they completely trusted that the prophecies would come true. And it was faith that enabled them to recognize Jesus in all his frailty and newness. As people of God, we have faith even when it feels as if we have none, when we're unhappy or things don't go our way. Simeon and Anna are signposts to remind us that God is a God of all that was past, all that is present, and all that is to come. I wonder where the signposts are in your life. As we go through our lives, we will see signs. Sometimes they're straightforward. Sometimes we choose to go past and ignore them. Sometimes they'll keep cropping up again and again. Perhaps there are things in your life that keep calling to you that you've been ignoring. I imagine you might be wondering why I've got this lantern. It's not exceptionally bright, but you can see it wherever I stand. If I was to move over there, you'd be able to see it. I could probably move most places. However, if I was to pretend to put it behind this pillar and take it out of your view of sight, it's vanished. Just like the beacons we heard about earlier, which needed to be built on high places so there was nothing to obstruct the view, the pillar blocks our vision. The pillar represents the things that we put up to block God's light from us. Our baggage, our worries, all our problems, our sins. I wonder what your pillars feel like to you. How heavy are your burdens and your worries? How do we get rid of them? The pillars are huge. They're solid and tremendously heavy. To help find the solution, we look back at our gospel reading to Simeon and Anna. They trusted in God, and the good news is that God loves us so much that there is no obstacle, no matter how big or how strong, that God would not remove in an instant if we but call his name. The signposts are God's trust and hope in us that we will do just that.